Hello class 6 students, welcome to the online class of physics, and this is the second session of the physics chapter. In the first session we have studied about matter, its meaning, states of matter and properties of solid, liquid and gas. We have also studied that all types of matter is made up of very small particles known as atoms or molecules. Now the smallest particle of matter is atoms. In this video we'll study about the characteristics of particulates of matter. As we know, atoms are the smallest particles of matter. When two or more atoms combine, they form molecule. When two or more atoms combine, they form molecule, and molecules are attached by the strong attractive forces known as intermolecular force of attraction. So we'll study about the characteristics of molecules. So the first characteristics of molecules, small in size. The particles of matter are small in size and cannot be seen even by a standard microscope. They are very, very small that they cannot be seen under a microscope also. The second characteristics is intermolecular space. There are spaces between the particles of matter called intermolecular spaces. It varies from object to object and it varies from states of matter also. Like we have studied, in case of solid, intermolecular space is negligible. In case of liquids, intermolecular space is more. And in case of gases, intermolecular space is very large. Now the third characteristics is constant motion of particles. The particles of matter move randomly in all possible directions in a zigzag path. This irregular motion is called Brownian motion. It is due to the random motion of particles that we are able to smell a perfume sprayed in any corner of the room. You have experienced it that if we sprayed a perfume in any room, we can feel the smell in every corner of the room and even outside the room also. The first characteristics is particles always attract each other. There are intermolecular forces of attraction between the particles, which constitute the molecules, and they attract the other particles too. The magnitude of this force varies from one type of matter to another, thus depending upon the nature of matter. We have studied also that in case of solids, the intermolecular force of attraction is very large. In case of liquid, the intermolecular force of attraction is little bit less. And in case of gases, the intermolecular attraction is negligible because the particles are very far from each other. So, we have studied characteristics of particulates of matter, that they are small in size and there is a space between the molecules that is known as intermolecular space. They are in constant motion or random motion. And they are attached by a force of attraction known as intermolecular force of attraction. Previously, we have studied about matter, states of matter, properties of solid, liquid and gas, and characteristics of particulates of matter. And in this session, we will study the difference between the solid, liquid and gas. So let's start. Difference between solids, liquid and gas. We have studied the properties of solid, liquid and gas. So difference is based on that only. So the first property is mass. In case of solids, they have definite mass. Liquids also have definite mass, but gases, they have not definite mass. The second property is shape. The shape of the liquid solids are definite. The liquids takes the shape of the container, and the gases also takes the shape of the container. Volume. Solids have definite volume. Liquids also have definite volume, but in case of gas, they have indefinite volume. Their volume is not definite. The fourth property is compressibility. If we pressurize these matter, the states of matter, so how they behave? The solids cannot be compressed. Liquids can be compressed a little, and gases can be easily compressed because there is a lots and lots of space between the molecules. Now the next property is fluidity. Fluidity means tendency to flow. So solids cannot flow. Liquids can flow. And gases can flow in any direction. They are moving randomly in different direction. The next property is rigidity. The solids are highly rigid. Like your table, your chair, your mobile phone, they all are highly rigid. Liquids are less rigid as compared to solids. And gases are not at all rigid. Now the next property is packing of particles. Packing of particles means the packing of molecules. So in case of solids, the molecules are very closely packed. In liquids, the molecules are less closely packed. And in gases, they are least closely packed because the molecules are very far from each other. Intermolecular force of attraction. So the attraction between the molecules. In case of solids, intermolecular force of attraction is very large. In case of liquids, they have large intermolecular force of attraction, but less than solids. And in case of gases, they have least or negligible force of attraction. Expansion on heating. When we heat these states of matter, solids, liquid and gas, then they'll expand or not. So in case of solids, there is very low expansion in case of solids, and in case of liquids, expansion is more than solids, and in case of gas, expansion is more than liquids. Now, examples of solids are, as we all know also, wood, chair, car, brick. Examples of liquid, water, milk, juices, petrol, and examples of gases are air, perfume, the cooking gas we use at home. Your home assignment for today's work is compare the properties of solids, liquid and gases on the basis of these properties. The first property is compressibility. The second property is fluidity. And the third property is rigidity. So I hope you have understood this difference between the solid, liquid and gas. I request you to watch this video again and again so that you can understand the topics very well. So this completes our chapter matter, and after this I'll upload the lesson plan of this chapter. You'll make one interleaf copy for physics and do all the lesson plan work in your fair copy, and the work of worksheet and the home assignments you will do in one rough copy. Thank you for watching.